वेलकम व्यूअर्स। सो इन दिस सेशन, दिस इज अवर थर्ड सेशन ऑन स्कैप्स ट्रेनिंग। सो आई विल बी टॉकिंग अबाउट, आई विल बी एम्फसाइजिंग ऑन द पॉइंट अबाउट साइंटिफिक पब्लिकेशंस फ्रॉम यूजिंग स्कैप्स। सो बिफोर गोइंग सो आई विल जस्ट शो यू वन ऑफ द स्ट्रेंथ ऑफ द स्कैप्स, लाइक यू कैन सिमुलेट योर सोलर सेल पैरामीटर विद इल्यूमिनेशन इंटेंसिटी ऑल्सो। सो यू टेम्परेचर वी हैव ऑलरेडी सीन, frequency, so all those things are there. I will be covering one by one all those things. So today I will be showing about how you can simulate your solar cell parameter with illumination intensity variation, say from 0.1 sun to 10 sun, like that. So you can vary the intensity automatically in SCAPS. So how to do so? So you see this illumination, if I click here, this is okay. So this is I will select it 0. Now see, this neutral density is 0, that means it is showing the intensity of 1000 watt per meter square, that is one sun. Okay, so neutral density, if I vary, it will automatically vary the solar cell incident power. Okay, so it will vary the sun equivalent intensity. What I mean to say that, if I increase it from 0 to say 0.1, when am I increasing it, the intensity is reducing, so the sun strength is going down. If I put 1, okay, ND1, neutral density is 1, what is happening here? It has 100 watt per meter square. So this is equivalent to 0.1 sun, okay? So if I put 2, this value is to 10 watt per meter square. So this is equivalent to 0.01 sun, okay? So sun intensity is reducing when I increasing the ND filter. If I reduce it, so it is 0, then the sun strength is 1. Now if I reduce it, say minus 1, so I am reducing the negative side, okay, point minus 1. So minus 1, the sun strength is 10 sun, you see. So like that, this thing can be automated using batch setup. So go to batch setup, go to add. Now here select the illumination, you see this illumination is coming, you select the illumination. Now in this you select ND filter. Once you select ND filter, select it, and then this will give you, so I have already selected, see, minus 1, 0, 0.1, 1, 2. So this ND values I have all, neutral density values I have already selected. So what to do here? I have already shown that which ND value is equivalent to what sun. So this thing you can, there is a one particular formula there is in the SCAPS manual. One can go and visit there. So that is this transmission power is transmission which is shown here. So transmission that is given by 10 to the power minus ND. Okay, so that is one particular formula. Using that, the relation between neutral density and incident power is being there. Okay, so now you have an understanding like what ND values corresponding to what sun intensity. Okay, so this thing is now I have automated. Now I, what parameter I want to say, I want to vary VOC with temperature illumination variation. So I will select VOC. Insert a work. Okay, now I can straightforward run this thing, just calculate recorder. So this is my recording the VOC values for these particular ND values. So now for ND values, I know which ND value corresponds to which sun illumination. So I can get a graph between VOC voltage value and with, so this is ND value low minus, so this means sun strength is high. So you see, sun intensity or illumination intensity is increasing, our VOC is increasing. Okay, so this is how you can simulate sun in your or any of the parameter with variation in the illumination intensity, with variation in the neutral density values. And I have already shown you that how neutral density is corresponding to the sun strength. Then you can have a direct relation from sun intensity to your simulated parameter. Okay, so this is about one of the strength of the SCAPS. Now for publications point of view, the SCAPS is a very handy tool, say like impurity photovoltaics, like multi junctions, like hysteresis, ion migration hysteresis. You can simulate like device configuration. You can simulate like whatever thing you are coming up with in your mind, whatever like you have understanding of the p-n junction heterojunction device physics, you can simulate it in this CAPS. You can have a like defect model and then you can simulate it, and depending upon your analysis, depending upon your intuitiveness, depending upon your thought, how well you write it, how well you present it, you can have a good scientific publication out of this. So this SCAPS community is growing, and there are a lot more material, a lot more literature available. So if one have the good p-n junction understanding, then he can come up with different ways. So you can like increase the efficiency, you can come up with a optimized device structure. Say you can implement say intrinsic layer in between a p-n junction. You can say tunneling layer you can implement in between p-n junction. You can come up with Fermi level optimization, Fermi level pinning kind of things. You can come up with defect tolerant structures. So all those things can be done. So I would like you to tell me what thing should I cover here, so that I also learn in the process, and we have a good discussion, and we improve our understanding. So yes, you please tell me, you please let me know which thing shall we discuss, and I'm waiting for your comments. Okay, thank you for watching, and I have given the links in the description, whereby you can if you have any issues and problems, or if you have anything to discuss, we can discuss there. Okay, thank you, thanks once again.